Just to tell you that, please, always when you're starting to learn, you should see, always have something that you want to do with your life. We call it like a dream, what you want to be. So everybody say loudly, I have a dream.
I have a dream.
And then you can add on pilot, doctor, president. And that is a very nice dream. So, but you need to be very strong, very strong, very, very strong to be able to be our future president. What is your name?
Okello Matias.
Who?
Okello Matias.
So you say Okello president. Say it.
Okello president.
Yeah, that is really nice. But please, each one of you, you should just think hard, see whether you are... You want to be a teacher, if you want to be a preacher, if you want to be a nurse or pilot, but everybody of you should have a dream.
And this is about the princess and the bee, a pea. Does everybody know what a princess is?
Yes.
You know what a princess is? You know how to find a princess? Does anybody know how to find a princess? Well, I tell you the story how the prince found his princess. There was once a princess who wished to be married to a prince. There was once a prince who wished to marry a princess, but a real princess she had to be. So he traveled all over the world to find one. Yet in every case something was wrong. Princesses were there in plenty, yet he could never be sure that they were genuine article. There was always something this or that that just didn't seem as it should be. At last he came back home, quite downhearted, for he did not want to have a real princess. One evening there was a fearful storm. Thunder raged, lightning flashed, rain poured down in torrents. It was terrifying. In the midst of it all, someone knocked on the palace door. You know what a palace door is? A palace is a big, wonderful house where the prince is living. And standing in front of the door was a princess. But goodness, what state she was in. The water ran down her hair and her clothes were all dirty and wet. Still, she said she was a real princess. Well, we'll find out soon enough, said the prince, the old queen thought. She didn't say a word though, but went into a spare bedroom and took off all the bedclothes and laid a little pea on the mattress. Then she piled up 20 more mattresses on top of the pea. So the pea was lying on the bed, and then he piled up 20 mattresses, very, very high, and told the princess to lie down to sleep the night. When morning came, they asked her how she had slept. So what do you think the princess said? How did she sleep? She slept on 25 mattresses piled on top of a tiny little beam. And the princess said, oh, shockingly, not a wink of sleep the whole long night. Heaven knows what was in the bed, but I lay on something hard that has made me black and blue all over. It was quite dreadful. Now they were sure that she was a real princess, since she had felt the pea through 25 mattresses. Only a real princess could be so sensitive as to feel the pea through 25 mattresses. So the prince married her, no need to search any further. The pea was put in a museum. You can go and see it for yourself if it hasn't been stolen. And that's the story for you. Any questions? Hey. So, Farida? Next story.
Hello, everybody. My name is Farida, and my story is about Nambi and Chintu. These are the first human beings according to the Baganda culture. Baganda are the people who live in the central of Uganda. They say that the history of Buganda which is in the central of the country, Uganda, where we are, started with a lady called Nambi, and the husband was called Chintu. Those were the two first people in this place. The story starts when they are here, so probably we shall say they were created by God. And these were Baganda. But they had a way to communicate with God. That was the God that they used to communicate to. But amongst the lesson was definitely for the love of little children. And then also on top of that, encourage them to have love for one another. And also little children should love each other. And we should all produce to expand. So that is the little story, that, and the lesson is for you to love one another, to fear, and then also to be able to multiply. I don't know, maybe multiply is such a heavy word. Do you know what I mean? Produce, we have many and many more children. Okay, but that is my story, and I hope you can learn the lessons of loving one another, keep interested in studies, and the fear of God. Yeah. Most of you here are Christians. Yeah, do you pray?
Yes.
Yeah, you should always pray. So I thank you so much.
La 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 la. Alleluia. La 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 la.
Alleluia.
La 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 la.
Alleluia.
La 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 la. Christ was born in Bethlehem.
Alleluia.
Son of God and the Son of Man.
Alleluia.
Oh, come and praise the Lord our King.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Come and praise the Lord our King.
Alleluia.
Oh, come and praise the Lord our King.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Come and praise the Lord our King.
Alleluia.
Jesus died at Calvary.
Alleluia.
Rose again triumphantly.
Alleluia.
Oh.
I shall have a Hajet Nam Farida, Uganda is proud of you.